Hello guys, welcome to my channel Maths for Street. Today we are going to look into question number 1, beat 8 from exercise 1.4 of chapter 1 called Real Numbers. So let's see what we have in this question. So coming to the question, it is given like without actually performing the long division, state whether the following rational numbers will have a terminating decimal expansion or a non-terminating repeating decimal expansion. And the given number is 6 by 15. Guys, we already did similar type of questions previously. So I believe this is going to be a very easy question to solve. So let's see how we can solve this question. Now moving ahead to the solution. We need to find out whether the below rational number will have a terminating decimal expansion or a non-terminating repeating decimal expansion. And the given number is 6 by 15. Guys, we are not going to do any long division or long division calculation. Just looking at the question, we need to determine whether the given rational number is terminating or non-terminating repeating decimal. This is what clearly mentioned in the question. So for this purpose, we are interested to know the factors of the denominator to see if it is of the form 2 to the power n and 5 to the power m. Guys, we very well know the theorems. There are three theorems: theorem 1.5, theorem 1.6, and theorem 1.7. If you haven't gone through those three theorems, I would request you to kindly go through my videos on these three theorems, which I already made, and it is available now for your views. So go through these theorems. These theorems will give you a clear picture how to determine if a given rational number is terminating or non-terminating. So guys, let's move ahead. Now, let us now find the factors of the denominator, that is 15. So coming to 15, 15 is divisible by 3. So after dividing 15 with 3, we are getting 5. And again, we could see that 5 is divisible by 5 itself. So after dividing by 5, we are getting here 1. So now our calculation stops here. Now I can write 15 is equal to 3 into 5. Or I can say that 6 by 15 is equal to 6 by 3 into 5. Or I can say that 6 by 3 into 5 is nothing but 2 by 5. Because we can eliminate the again common factors. So after eliminating the common factors, my new number is 6 by 15 is equal to 2 by 5. Now guys, in order to put the denominator in the form of 2 to the power n and 5 to the power m, what I will do, just I will multiply 2 in the numerator and 2 in the denominator. Because we already have 5 in the denominator, so just I want to add another 5 in the denominator. For that reason, I'm multiplying 2 in the numerator and 2 in the denominator. And guys, we already know that if we do the same type of multiplication in the numerator and denominator, it will have no effect. Okay, so for that reason, I'm doing this calculation. Now, after multiplying 2 in the numerator and 2 in the denominator, I am getting 4 by 2 to the power 1 into 5 to the power 1. So guys, now we got the equation in the form 2 to the power n and 5 to the power m. Now it is very easy for everyone, each one of us, to know what exactly this tells. Hence, as the denominator is of the form 2 to the power n and 5 to the power m, we can easily say that this rational number is a terminating rational number. Hope guys, you understood this calculation. If you still have any questions or confusions, kindly reach out to me in the comment section of my videos. I will definitely get back to you once I see your comments. If you really like my videos, kindly subscribe and let your friends know. Thank you. Bye.